Good afternoon. Today we're going to learn about the basics of cell culturing. To start, you're going to want to gather all of your supplies so you're ready to go within the biosafety cabinet. Next, you're going to want to grab a pair of gloves and spray them with 70% ethanol like so. After you spray and wipe down your gloves, you're going to want to move towards the biosafety cabinet. The biosafety cabinet is this right here, and you're going to want to raise the sash until you get to this mark right here, the sash height line. You're going to raise it until the lights of the cabinet turn on. The cabinet will keep alarming until you've reached the proper height and the lights have turned on. The cabinet blower does not begin right away, as there will be about a 30-second delay. Do not start moving into the cabinet until the blowers have fully turned on. After the blowers have turned on, you're going to want to spray the inside of the cabinet with 70% ethanol to make sure the area is sanitized properly. Make sure to spray the entire area of the cabinet, including the sides of the walls. You may leave the napkin inside the biosafety cabinet just in case you encounter any spills in the future. After you have properly sanitized your cabinet, you will begin spraying all of your supplies and putting them inside the cabinet. It is important to note, whenever you're working with your cells, you will never directly spray any of your samples with the ethanol, but every fomite that you put inside there will get sprayed with ethanol, minus the serological pipettes, which you'll see in just a moment. You will want to grab serological pipette tips, a 5 mL, a 10 mL, and a 25 mL, and you'll place these inside your biosafety cabinet.